So good afternoon, everybody. I hope that you can hear me. So I'm Celia Di Giorgio. No. Oh, now? OK. I'm Celia Di Giorgio. I'm a PhD student at the University of Würzburg in Germany. And today I would like to talk about Gratitude, a computational tool for gradSeq data analysis. So we know that RNA-RNA and RNA-protein interactions play an important role in post-transcriptional gene regulation. We also know that studying this interaction is relevant to understand the regulatory network of cellular systems. So far, no techniques was able to analyze the interaction of RNAs and protein at the same times. For this reason, a new method to study the complexome was required. To globally study the interaction of RNA and protein at the same times, in our lab, they developed a new technique called gradSeq. gradSeq is an output profiling approach that separates based on molecular weight and shape and size, including, for example, RNA-protein complexes. These are separated on a Grisserov gradient. This fractionation, after this fractionation, for each of the 21 fractions generated, mass spectrometry and RNA sequencing was performed. This allows the reconstruction of the in-gradient behavior profiling of each of the RNA and proteins, and also with the further analysis, like cluster analysis, you can see the if there are similarity between the different molecules. Gratitude in order to analyze gradSeq data, we developed a new tool called Gratitude. Gratitude so far has 20 different subcommands. And for example, we have a normalized subcommands, we also have a cluster subcommands, PCA, TSNA, and several more. Today, I would just like to show some example of real E. coli gradSeq data. These outputs are all generated using the Gratitude tool. So this is the first example. It's like a kinetics that show like the in-gradient behavior of a specific transcript or a specific protein. In this case, this is Chi-X, a small RNAs. And then the second example that I would like to show is a TSNE plot, of course generated using the Bokeh library. And with this, you can actually see if there are similarity between different between RNAs. This is like an example using sequencing data, but can be used also for protein data. Then we try to find a way to connect the two data sets, like the mass spectrometry data set and the sequencing data, and we came up with a network plot based on correlation coefficient. This actually helped us to see if there are interactions between RNAs and specific proteins. So this is the last example. It's an interactive plot. So it's a TSNE plot, but I would just like to point out the fact that this is totally interactive and totally explorable. So far, Gratitude has been used to predict possible interaction in many organisms, including E. coli, Enterococcus faecalis, Enterococcus faecium, and several more. Next step, of course, we would like to share the data and make it public, and we would like to implement further interaction prediction approaches and also a way to deal with the future replicates. So far, we can say that Gratitude offers a way to analyze sequencing data and mass spectrometry data, a way to normalize read counts of fractions, and a way to study RNA or protein behavior within the gradients, and also a way to predict RNA-RNA or RNA-protein interaction using machine learning approaches, and a way to interactively visualize and explore data sets. If you want to know more about Gratitude, I will present a poster tomorrow. My poster is B8. And if you also want to know more about Redemption, a pipeline that can be used for the RNA-seq data analysis, you can go today to my colleagues will present a poster, the B13, about Redemption 2, from reads to knowledge. And with this, I would like to thank my supervisor, Professor Dr. Konrad Forstner. I would also like to thank my collaborator in the lab, Jens Ohr, and all my group. And I would also like to thank you for the attention.